Okay, welcome. We got Mark Kinzer back, and he's going to do responding to partners takeout double. Have I got the screen shared? Can everybody see it?
Yes.
Looks good here.
All right, take her away.
All right. Well, Mark's fine introduction said it all. Why don't we go to the first slide here? Okay, so let's assume that our left-hand opponent has opened and our partner has made a takeout double. We've got a bunch of options on how to respond to that. I list them here on the slide. You can respond in a new suit at the one level. You can jump in a new suit. You can bid no trump, Q bid. And each of the subsequent slides will talk about those various options, what sort of hand you need to make those bids. Next. First and most commonly, you're just going to respond in a new suit. That said, this is one where people often get it wrong. How many points do you have when you've been in a new suit? Well, you could have the first hand. That's a nice 7 count, a 5 card suit. You could have, but oftentimes you have quite a bit less than that. You could have a 3 count. and still have to respond one spade. Or the final example on this slide, you could have a 0 count and still have to respond because partner has made a takeout double. You must take it out.
Zero, really?
In fact, when I was playing a couple days ago, my partner had basically the last hand, except he had a pair of jacks. And he had no choice but to bid. And in fact, he bid in a 3-card suit because that's all he had. Next slide, please. Now, what if you have a little bit better hand? This slide discusses jumping in a new suit. What does that mean? Well, we find it, this is a very standard way of playing, by the way. I'm not introducing anything that's unusual or unique to my group of friends. This is very standard. It's not necessarily intuitive, but a jump in a new suit shows 9 to 11. May only have only a 4-card suit, however, as in the second example here. You might have a 5-card suit, but you might also have a 4-card suit. Notice in the middle hand, by the way, I'm suggesting that you jump in two spades, even though you have a 5-card diamond suit to go with your jack, fourth of spades. That's because emphasis is always going to be on the majors. You know, that's pays the most for game. And if you can bid again, you can bid diamonds, and partners should know that you have only 4 spades. Probably, and quite often 5 diamonds.
I don't know. What do you think?
Janice, can you mute, please?
Okay, what do you say? It looks very, very nice, but
damn, it's
bright.
All right, there we go. I think I got her.
Next slide, please.
All right.
This next example is a very rare bid, but it comes in quite handy. It's much like preempting opening 2-bid. When you jump 2 levels, so 1 club double pass and you bid 3 spades, it looks like this. You have a 6-card suit and it's preemptive. You have like 3 to 6 points. It's useful for partner has at least 3 spades, and so with 9 trumps between the 2 hands, you want to be playing at the 3 level, and this is the sort of hand it shows. Very rare, but happy when it comes up. We'll move to the next slide. This is quite common too, where you have a balanced hand, you don't have a particularly good major, you have a concentration of strength in opener suit, and you want to show some points. You can bid 1 no trump, that shows maybe 7 to 11. You can jump in 2 no trump, that shows 12 or 13. And if you have more than that, well, you can jump 3 no trump, you can Q bid. Just be happy when it comes up. But remember, partner, for his takeout double, just assume that partner has a 4-by-1. They have a singleton in the suit that they are doubling, and they have 4-card support for the other 3 suits. So you should bid no trump only if you think that's going to be best opposite that exact shape. Next. A qubit is also quite common. This shows 12 or more points and is forcing until one of the suits is raised. So on the first example, you would qubit with two clubs and partner would bid, say, two hearts, and you would bid two spades. That's forcing, saying, partner, I have four or more spades and 12 or more points. And if partner raises to three spades, that's not forcing, but all other new suits are forcing. Second example, that's an even better hand and not necessarily expected that you will also have shortness because the opponents, that means, have a lot of clubs, but it's just a way to show the hand. And the third example, that's a real minimum there with 13 points and you're hoping to find a fit in one of the majors. Remember, you think of a partner as being 4-4-4-1 for this auction.
So you bid two clubs.
Right, in all three of these examples, you qubit two clubs.
You can also have, couldn't you have like even a five card suit here? You could be a little more distributional, right?
Oh yes, you could have a right. Seven card suit, absolutely.
Right, okay. You're just asking partner, you know, you're pushing it back to them, right?
Yeah, you're saying, partner, I have a good hand and I'm about to tell you more about it on my next call.
Okay, thank you.
Oftentimes it's a complex hand and you need multiple bids to describe it. This is also a fairly rare thing, but great fun when it happens. And this is where you pass partner's takeout double. What is this? My late great father was not much of a card player, and we were playing with him at the dining room table, and he passed a takeout double, and his explanation was, "Well, I had nothing to bid." That's not why you pass takeout doubles. It's because you have every hope of setting the opponent's suit. So these are the first two examples here are the sorts of hands you want to have. The third hand is not a good example of passing a takeout double apart. Think of left-hand opponent as having like the queen, jack, 10, nine, all those club spots that you don't have, and they're all gonna take tricks. Your ace, king of clubs are only gonna take two tricks. So think about the intermediate spots as far as whether passing is a good idea.
You'd be leaning towards exploring no trump with you know, right?
With the third example, right.
Yeah, right, okay, yep.
And this is a very common question too. Oftentimes your opponents are not cooperative and silently passing as you guys bid to your best spot. So what happens if they respond one heart? Well, you now are no longer obligated to bid. If you have your zero count or your three count and nothing much to say, you can pass. But if you have a few points, say my kind of rule of thumb is 5 points or more, now you can start thinking about bidding your best suit. Example one is a perfect minimum. I would be delighted to bid one spade with that hand in that auction. Example two, you'd bid two diamonds. Example three, is another higher level. It goes one club, double, two hearts. And I think with that five carat suit and a 10 count, you're happy to bid three diamonds with that hand. And the one additional bit, or the last bit I want to cover here is a qubit.
I just want to do that one before it. So particularly on that third one here, because that two hearts is probably a weakish bid. You need to tell partner you're alive. Right? I guess is my thought that you've got.
Yes,
something.
Exactly. Exactly.
Yep. Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Sorry.
You're not so alive that you have a qubit, however. The right. Final hand, just like always, a qubit shows 12 points and not necessarily a clear direction. And so feel free to qubit, even when the right-hand opponent has responded with a suit. You can qubit to say, hey, it's still our hand, partner. I've still got something here. Pay no attention
was
to that.
Little fast there, sorry.
Yeah, no problem. And I think this is my final slide. What if there is a redouble? Oh. Well, now all of a sudden, left-hand opponent has 12, right-hand opponent has 10 or more. Our side probably doesn't have too much. Partner has a dozen or so for his takeout double, so you are not expected to have much. But you still have to take out partner's takeout double if you have a clear bid. So on the first example here, you bid one heart. That's the only four card suit I have outside of opener suit. And so just show it, but it could only be a one count like that. The second example is even more fun. You know, partner has some support for all the unbid suits here, and so you can feel free to jump around if you have some extra length. And I think this example is a perfect two spade bid in this auction. And it's great fun. The opponent say, "What does that mean? You can't have 10 points. What are you jumping with?"
And the reason you can't have 10 points is that redouble is saying that they've got 10 or more points. You know, that's their hand.
It's their hand. So yeah. You want to preempt them. You want to raise the level and make it tougher for them to find their spots.
Yep.
Last slide, I think, is just a closer.
Oh, I can't. It's not scrolling down for me. Oh, well. Maybe this was the last slide. It's not moving. Oh, well.
Okay, very good.
I can go back to the, we'll go back to the, all right, any questions for Mark?
Wow, I must have done a perfect job today.
Well, I did mute.
I was golfing.
I muted some people, so that could be part of the problem too. All righty, guys, thanks for joining us. And then if you need a partner, let me know. And put your name at the partnership desk and we'll see you over at the game.
And refer to this deck often because this is an important lesson.
Yeah, and these and this actually take your time with it because these are some sequences where, as you could see, the bid, depending on the spot, meant different things. So if you have questions about it, you can reach out and we can go over that. Thanks again.
Yeah,
and
this is a very common sequence. So
yep. Mm-hmm. Thanks. Well, thanks again, Mark.
Thank you. Have a great Earth Day next week.
All right. We will.
Bye, everybody. Bye.